Hey guys, Wet Movie One back here again, and it's time to go hoard up. Are you guys ready? I know I sure am. Stay tuned to the end of this video, because I'm going to be doing a giveaway in this video for a new Blu-ray of Pauly Shore's new movie, Guest House, that's now out on Blu-ray and everything like that. And if you guys want to know how to win, you're definitely going to have to follow me on my Instagram, which I have a link for in the description box of this video. So I'll be doing a giveaway on there, so you guys have to follow me on there. But yeah, stay tuned to the end of the video so you guys know how you guys can win one. But today, a handful of things are hitting Blu-ray and 4K and all that jazz today, like V for Vendetta, Antebellum. Those two movies I'll be talking about at the end of this video. Pretty decent flicks. Also, we're getting a Best Buy exclusive 4K of Kick-Ass here, steelbook-wise, out there at Best Buy today. That's one of the things that's coming out, along with Game of Thrones, the complete series on 4K. Warner Brothers sent me a copy over here to showcase for you guys for a video, and Best Buy, I believe, is also having a steelbook packaging version of the same set out there. You know, the same kind of way Lionsgate put out Rambo on 4K and those like steelbook, you know, kind of sets with how they kind of like separated out and stuff, but with styrofoam. That's out there in the stores today. If you're a fan of Game of Thrones, let me know down below in the comments of this video. I still have yet to see any episodes of it yet, to be honest. But yeah, if you're a fan of Game of Thrones, let me know. Good, bad, should I pass? You know, kind of thing. Let me know in the comments down below. But also, stay tuned to the end of this video, like I said, for a couple of new DVD and Blu-ray and 4K reviews. And, yeah, let's head on out of here. Let's go to our first spot of the day. But before I do, hit that thumbs up button. Let's see if we can get to 400 thumbs up on this video. Can we do it? 400 thumbs up. And also, drop a comment down below saying, hello. Let's go. Well, guys, at my first stop of the day, the thrift shop. Last time I was here, it was temporarily closed. Well, they are open, so it is kind of just sporadic on how these places open and close. They kind of just do it as they please. But when it comes to this place, there's not really a whole lot of DVDs. It's mostly, you know, big bookcases of VHS tapes. And of course, you know, we get four copies of Titanic up there. And they're priced at $5 each for the Titanic VHS tapes. I'll pass on that for now, but yes, all I really see is just like stacks and stacks of you know, VHS tapes in here. This movie was actually really cool. Was as good as it gets back in the day. That was pretty decent flick, and I don't know, like, I may not spend that much time in here since it's mostly, you know, VHS tapes and stuff, but you know, there could be something cool to see or cool to find in here. Maybe some like obscure like old obscure horror movies or something like that. You never know, but if I do come across anything, you know, I'll let you guys know. Well, that place was kind of pointless to go into. They haven't changed up anything in there in a long time. But they do have wedding dresses. Ooh. From the thrift store to the Dollar Tree. Let's see if they have any movies this time around. I know quite possibly this is pointless as hell, but with the Dollar Trees out here, you never know when they're gonna come. So there's nothing up front in that little weekly wow section. Let's walk around to the other part and see if they see if you see anything. Well, it looks like the only movies they have is this little row right here of the same old stuff they couldn't get rid of for the last, like, you know, handful of months or maybe even a year. Right here, that Yogi Berra thing right there, and they have a whole bunch of those and a whole bunch of that Dennis Leary, you know, comedy special right here. Something called The Back Nine. Not a whole lot, but I had to come and check. Anyway, off at the next stop of the day, Wally World. Let's go see what they got. Well, guys, I'm gonna need a cart for this adventure right here. There's something I need to get, something I'm trying to do that involves this. That involves this right here, potatoes. There's something I may be trying in the upcoming week or two. Something I may be trying when it comes to potatoes. So I gotta get a handful of them. I gotta get a handful of them. Oh shit, they're falling between my legs right now. Like my nutsack. I'm gonna get some rustic, and I guess I'll get a bag of yellow ones for now. Stay tuned for an upcoming video when it comes to that. Maybe.
If you guys know anything about Penn Jillette and what he tried to do, I'm gonna see if I can do it too.
Well guys, in the movie section right now, and it looks like they have like new holiday slipcovers for holiday classic films like the Charlie Brown Christmas, the How the Grinch Stole Christmas, and you know, Elf and stuff. They usually do this kind of stuff, you know, during the holiday season just to see, you know, if they can like push more copies and stuff. But like Smallfoot and Polar Express and, you know, even A Christmas Story. A Christmas Story has a new, like, these are all like DVD, like new DVD slipcovers. Probably the same old discs that they had before, just like wrapped in a new slipcover. But oh no, there's a Blu-ray version of that. That's okay. That's cool. Just a couple of new holiday things, because it's a couple days after Halloween. Got to get into the Christmas spirit. But when it comes to the new release films, we got, of course, Annabellum right here from the producers of Get Out. This one right here is actually pretty decent. It's getting mixed reviews by different people that I've seen, you know, talk about the film and everything like that. But I watched it twice since I've gotten the 4K, once by myself and once with my mom. And I think she dug it too. But of course, they have all these different, you know, Hallmark specials. I don't know if these ones all just came out today, or if they're just putting these up here just to like fill up space. Right here, of course, we have one with you know, Candace Cameron right there. But other than that, I'm not seeing anything else that's like super newish that, you know, may have came out this week. Like maybe Hard Kill may have been one of those ones with Bruce Willis in it from Vertical Entertainment. But that I'm not 100% sure. I don't remember seeing that on Blu-ray.com. But other than that, it's kind of sparse. But at the same time, it still looks like they're still putting stuff out on the shelf over here. So there could be some other stuff that was released that they just don't have yet, like V for Vendetta and things like that. It also looks like this one came out today, The Last Train, with Lou Diamond Phillips and stuff. Never heard about this one before. Put up by Echo Bridge. Echo Bridge has been dumping out a lot of indie flicks lately. Well, it doesn't look like Walmart's carrying you know, Game of Thrones in any kind of version of the 4K today, V for Vendetta, and even Guest House. I believe Guest House, a new Polly Shore flick, was coming out today. I could be wrong on that one, but you know, as you can tell over here at Walmart, they're still putting stuff out. And I'm not gonna be able to hit up Best Buy today. Kind of don't want to go all the way, you know, over there today. I have a couple of other things going on personally with the family and stuff. But let's go to our last stop of the day. Well, at my last stop of the day, El Super Bisto, or El Super Target. Let's go. Well, guys, when it comes to Target this week, it doesn't look like there's really anything different whatsoever when it comes to the new release rack today. But maybe they might have some different deals going on in here, even though the movie section seems to be getting smaller and smaller, you know, because they're like being taken over. Like, CDs are making its comeback. It seems like CDs are making a comeback over here at certain places, you know what I mean? And like, movies are slowly sort of, you know, records and CDs are coming back, and movies are slowly kind of like, you know, coming, you know, getting out of here. They do have Game of Thrones, but this is like the DVD edition of the complete series right here. I'm not seeing it in stores. It could be at the Best Buy that I can't get to today, but it's all good. It's all good. The Star Wars movie's on 4K. The Force Awakens is $19.99 today if you want the standalone version of it over here at Target on 4K. But other than that, not really seeing really much of anything different over here, guys. Doesn't look like people are restocking the shelves when it comes to the new physical media over here. And this just caught my eye over here, this WWE Legends display, which looks like, you know, for new Elite action figures. Looks like all of them are sold out already, for the exception of, what's his name, Paul Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful, they have over here. And there was one on the side that was over here that wasn't in the display, of Jake the Snake Roberts. For you guys that didn't know, I am a wrestling fan, but old school wrestling fan, and these figures are actually kind of cool. And it says they have an Ultimate Warrior one in this line, like old man Ultimate Warrior, you know, kind of one on here, but I didn't see that one here. But I'm also not gonna start collecting the toys. I used to have a bunch of them when I was a kid, old school ones that are going for shit tons of money now. But yeah. Well guys, getting out of Target now, didn't really come across anything I needed to get up on. Then, like I said, it didn't look like they restocked the shelves when it comes to the new release titles of the week, even some of those catalog titles that was released, not even Annabellum right there. But right now, guys, let's head on home and for some DVD and Blu-ray reviews.
And I think I got a box. I think I got a box in the mail. My sister just texted me. So let's go home and unbox that too.
All right, guys, I'm back home now from a disappointing day out looking for physical media. A whole bunch of nothing. VHSs, stores not stocking the shelves correctly, or just not getting stuff in at all. But like I said, my sister gave me a text saying there's a box here for me, and it's coming from Kino Lorber. And this would be like the first thing I got from them review-wise in a while, like a company that puts out really cool DVDs and Blu-rays and stuff. This is the first time I've gotten something from them in a few years. I haven't really talked to the people that work for them in a while, and they're putting out something very special. At least to me, it's special because it involves my family. And I'm gonna open this up and let's see. Hopefully, it is what I think it is. It may be two things up in here, but let's find out together. And, ooh! Right off the top, it's exactly what I thought, man. It's exactly what I thought. There's actually two things in here, and I'll show you both of them in a second. And that's this bubble and paperwork. But the first one up in this package right here is a movie that came out in 1979, and it kind of holds a little special place in my heart and stuff. I mean, from what I remember when I was when I first saw it, I think it was like VHS or something way back in the day, like in the early 90s and stuff or whatever it was. And it's a movie called SOS Titanic. It's another, telling of the story of Titanic that, struck an iceberg that, split in half and, sunk into the ocean and everything like that. There's been many, many different incarnations of Titanic. Of course, James Cameron's one being the main one everyone knows and goes for these days. But the thing that makes this one special is that, because it's a movie I wasn't expecting to ever see a Blu-ray release. And to see it on Blu-ray is cool because my father is in this film. My dad is an extra in this movie right here. But it's just kind of cool to get something that he's in on Blu-ray, because there's another movie that he was in as well that came to Blu-ray too. I think through, like, I forgot what company it was, but it was called Shock 'Em Dead. And recently, Red Letter Media made a video talking about Shock 'Em Dead and some other horror movies for Halloween. And they said the best part of the movie was my dad. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. You know what I mean? My dad was in a lot of independent-ish kind of stuff back in the day. But this movie I haven't seen in forever. And it says it has a new 4K restoration from the theatrical cut version, and it also has a TV cut of the movie, audio commentary track, Titanic 1943 trailer, newsreels from 1912 when the Titanic went down, like a handful of stuff that they added to this right here. Let me unbox this real quick. This is to me just kind of special, even though, like I said, he's just an extra in this one. But like, I just remember the time that he showed me this and Shock 'Em Dead for the first time. I was like a kid, and I would go over to his house for the weekends because my parents were split up at the time. And every once in a while he would put in a movie and surprise me. I'm like, oh shit, he's in this. You know what I mean? Like, oh wait, why he's in? My dad was in like a featured extra in the movie Raging Bull with Robert De Niro back in the day. But yeah, you get two discs in here. The standard Kino discs right there, and it looks like you get some inside artwork. What do we get in there? Yeah, it's the alternate artwork for SOS Titanic here on Blu-ray. That is cool, man. That is cool. Like I said, he's been in a handful of other movies, like a movie called Lady in Red, like real obscure, obscure-ish kind of titles. But to get it on Blu-ray that you can get now from the Kino Lorber website or just anywhere you can buy Blu-rays online, you guys can get SOS Titanic if you guys like the Titanic story. Like I said, I haven't seen that incarnation in a long time, but I can't wait to revisit it. And the other thing that they have in that box right here was one of my favorite Spike Lee movies of all time, next to Do the Right Thing, and that is Crooklyn. Of course, like, just recently put this one out on Blu-ray right here. It doesn't look like there's any new special features to it or anything like that, but it's just about a family that lives in Brooklyn or Crooklyn, and it's just their ins and outs and how they're trying to just stay together and stay as a family unit and stuff like that, and just see what happens as the time goes on. And it has stars Alfie Woodard, who's also been one of my favorite actresses of all time ever since I saw her in this, and of course Heart and Souls from back in the day, when she plays one of the ghosts that come down to try to help out, Robert Downey Jr. and stuff. If you guys have never seen the movie Heart and Souls, I don't know what you guys are doing. But also, you guys gotta check out Crooklyn. Check out the trailer. If you guys like Spike Lee movies, This one will be right up your alley. I'm really excited to see the Blu-ray transfer on this one. It doesn't say like there's like a new 4K restoration or anything. It just has a 1080p transfer, but you know, an upgrade for sure. Because this is the first time I believe it's been on Blu-ray that I've known. You know what I mean? But that's all I have for that box right there. Thank you, Kino, for sending that on over. And if you guys want to get any of those two titles, make sure you guys check out the Kino Lorber website. I have a link for that in the description box of this video. But now on to the review portion of this video right here. I have three titles to talk to you guys about today. The first one up is from Warner Brothers. I got sent for free to review. And that is the new 4K edition of V for Vendetta here in a Blu-ray 4K combo pack and stuff. Of course, this is a movie that stars Natalie Portman and Hugo Weaving and stuff. Remember the 5th of September, right? Hopefully that's the right date. But this is the first time I've seen this movie in a very, very long time. This may have even been the first time I've seen it, because when I was watching it, it was like I didn't remember anything except for her shaving her head, you know, kind of thing for this movie. And if you guys have never seen it before, it's a pretty decent movie. It's one of those movies that kind of, When you watch it, especially in the way the world is now, it kind of is like, oh shit, you know what I mean? Like the way things are going with like elections and politicians and, you know, things like that. But the 4K transfer on this is absolutely stunning, in my opinion. And I know there's a Best Buy exclusive steelbook that's out there that came out today. But like I said, I couldn't get out to the closest Best Buy today because it's just a little bit farther. And I had to get back here because my sister, does her Zoom meetings, her Zoom classes. And my Ethan and Ari have their Zoom schools and stuff. And we're all here helping each other out as, you know, things go on. But V for Vendetta 4K Blu-ray. Great transfer. 2 hours of special features added onto this bad boy. Cool looking slipcover. Oh yeah. And you can't go wrong with some Natalie Portman, man. Come on, bro. Come on, Natalie Portman. But yeah, guys, like I said, there's also going to be a giveaway at the end of this video in the last movie I talk about, so stay tuned. Give it a couple more seconds here. But the next movie up I have right here is from Lionsgate Home Entertainment, and that's another movie that came out today, Antebellum, here on Blu-ray. And this right here, man, this movie, I didn't know what to expect from it. I didn't really read up on it. I didn't really watch many trailers, or any trailers for that matter, when I got this and popped it in. And I was blown away by it. You know what I mean? Then I watched a trailer afterwards, and I was just like, huh. That would have, you know, whatever you do, don't watch a trailer before watching this movie. Don't read the back. Just watch the movie. And it's a period piece film about these slaves on this plantation, and of course, you know, being mistreated and all that kind of stuff. And and it's kind of hard to explain this movie without ruining it for you, but it has a really to me a really decent twist to the film. And like I said, it's been getting really mixed reviews by people online, and I can kind of see why, because people said the third act kind of fell apart a little bit, but it still worked for me. You know what I mean? I'm like, I wasn't expecting, you know, what I was seeing in here. I can't get in depth with this review because, like I said, I don't want to spoil anything. But if you really watch this movie and really pay attention to every little thing that you're seeing on screen, you'd be like, wait a minute, what? You know what I'm saying? The directors and the writers of this movie really painted a really great picture when it comes to making this movie and having little Easter eggs, you know, throughout the film. Because I watched this movie twice. Once by myself and once with my mom, because I'm like, Mom, you have to check this out. And I just wanted to watch it to see if I picked up on any other, you know, different things that they were throwing out there and stuff. And it was great, man. Antebellum, I liked it. I really did like it. I suggest you guys check it out. It has a making of featurette on there with two of the writers and stuff talking about how they were, you know, piecing together the movie. I liked it. I really did. I thought it was pretty solid. But next up right here, and last up I have to talk to you guys about today, is from Lionsgate also, and that is Guest House here on Blu-ray. And if you guys want to win a copy of this on Blu-ray, Lionsgate's working with me for a giveaway copy. If you guys would like to get one of these, you guys have to make sure you guys, one, like this video, two, follow me on Instagram and like my post that I have of Pauly Shore up on my Instagram, the newest post I have up on my Instagram right now. And, you know, leave a comment down below letting me know what is your favorite Pauly Shore movie of all time in the comments on Instagram after you follow me on there. And I'll pick the winner, and I'll announce the winner in next Tuesday's Hoarding Up video. So stay tuned for that for sure. But this one right here is a new, like I said, a new Pauly Shore movie. It's directed by Sam Macaroni, who made a whole bunch of movies. Like, I believe Midgets vs. Mascots and things like that. Really, 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 really cool, really nice director. And but this movie, I'm not going to lie, I was expecting a little bit more from it. But it's about this new couple that's moving into their first home together, and they find out that there's a guy played by Pauly Shore who's always doing drugs and doing, you know, partying and doing crazy stuff, is living in the guest house. And as soon as they move in there, they're having all sorts of issues and problems with him partying in the back and inviting all these naked girls and doing all this crazy stuff. And it's pretty much about this young couple trying to get him out of there any way necessary. And it's just a war between the two, the guy in the guest house played by Pauly Shore and this, you know, newly together couple moving into their first home. And there's some really funny moments in here. You get Bobby Lee up in here as well. You get Steve-O in here playing, you know, doing his Jackass style kind of stuff, like busting through walls and things like that. You get a handful of cool appearances in this film. It has some deleted scenes and a behind the scenes making of a special feature on here, but I thought Pauly Shore did a damn good job. I don't know, for some reason I was expecting a little bit different from it. I don't know what it was, but I still enjoyed it. I'm happy that Pauly Shore is back in a leading role, doing his thug thizzle again. But if you guys want to win a copy of Guest House that Lionsgate will send you directly, make sure you guys follow me on my Instagram and like the post and leave a comment underneath of the post of me taking a picture with this Blu-ray, and let me know your favorite Pauly Shore movie is of all time, and I'll pick the winner and announce the winner on Tuesday. But guys, next Tuesday. But thank you guys for following me. Thanks for coming by for this adventure. But I appreciate you guys for all the support and love, and thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.